Big warm welcome to everybody. A special welcome to everybody who has come all the way to this particular place, this wonderful resort. Usually we do all our launch events in the middle of the city, which is heart of Delhi, usually at our favorite hotel, Hotel Lalit. You guys would have attended a lot of launch events over there. But this time we thought we will do something different. Because today the phone that we are launching is Mie 2. And the best part about Mie 2 is its camera. So we thought we'll bring you to this most wonderful resort in Delhi NCR. We did this video today morning about this resort. This is actually one of the most beautiful resorts that I've ever been to in India. And we thought we will call all of you guys here. Of course, many of you guys have Mie A2. Many of you guys will get hold of this device today. And I really hope you can take really beautiful pictures today evening in this wonderful resort. Coming back to Xiaomi. So as you guys know, Xiaomi is a pretty young startup. Started only 8 years ago by Lei Jun and few of our co-founders. And in 8 years, we have achieved a lot of milestones. But there's one thing that I'm particularly extremely excited about, which is us going public. This was perhaps the biggest milestone in our journey. Last month, we went public at Hong Kong Stock Exchange. There's a founder chairman, Lei Jun, in the middle with some of the other board members, our co-founders and other execs on stage. Usually, when a company goes public, there's a bell that you ring. In our case, Hong Kong Stock Exchange had a big gong to play over there. It was pretty incredible. Many of you guys also traveled for this amazing event. This was the largest tech IPO in the last 4 years. And we want to thank everybody, especially all our Mie fans. Thank you so much, guys, for supporting us during this incredible journey. You know, after we started using this term Mie fans, and we have a bunch of Mie fans here, a lot of other brands started copying it and started calling their consumers as fans. And we find it very funny. But I believe there's a difference between genuinely meaning it and just saying it. And let me show you how we truly mean or truly appreciate what Mie fans are for us. This is the picture of Lei Jun ringing that bell or that big gong. And the person next to him, the person with his hands high up, he is a Mie fan. He has been a big supporter of Xiaomi over the last 8 years. And I don't think there's any other company in the world which would have done something like this, getting a Mie fan or a consumer on stage when you're going public. I think Xiaomi is the only company which has ever done this. So we truly appreciate what Mie fans are for us. Let's talk a little bit about more about Xiaomi. So last year, which was the seventh year, 2017, globally we crossed a $15 billion revenue mark. Now, of course, today there are a lot more tech companies, internet companies, which are bigger than us. Companies like Google, Facebook, Alibaba, Tencent, and others. But each of these companies took a much longer time to cross the $15 billion revenue mark. Like Google took 9 years, Facebook 12, Alibaba and Tencent 17, and Apple took 20 years. And Xiaomi, only 7 years. So Xiaomi is the fastest growing tech company or internet company in the history of mankind. If you look at all these tech companies and look at their last year's growth rate, 2017's growth rate over 2016, of course, a lot of companies grew pretty fast, like Facebook, Tencent, and Alibaba. All of them grew between 45 to 55%. And Xiaomi grew at a whopping 67% year on year. Thank you. Today, Xiaomi would be the number one fastest growing internet companies on the planet, and the second fastest company amongst all companies, tech and non-tech. And this has been possible because of a unique philosophy of innovation for everyone, where we try and ensure that we make technology affordable for every single person. In the beginning of this year, we passed a new board resolution where we said we will never ever make more than 5% profit margin on any of our hardware devices. Usually, most of the companies have a lower limit, saying I will not make less than this much profit margin. Xiaomi is the only company which has an upper limit that we will never make more than 5% profit margins on our hardware products. And that's probably why we've been growing pretty fast. Today, we are the fourth largest smartphone maker in the world. And not just fourth largest, but the fastest growing smartphone brand in the world. If you look at the IDC numbers in Q2, we shipped 31.9 million units globally. And we grew almost 50% year on year. And we were the fastest growing smartphone company across the world. We are present in about 70 markets. And in about 15 of these 70 markets, we've already become one of the top 5 players. Number one in India, number one in Myanmar, number two in Indonesia. Even in Western Europe, countries like Greece and Spain, we are beginning to become number two and number three brands. And of course, in India, we have been the number one smartphone brand for 4 consecutive quarters. The Canalys report came out, the CMR report came out. Both of them say that we're the number one brand. Usually we show the IDC numbers on these slides. Unfortunately, the IDC report for Q2 is still not out. But if you look at the Canalys report, it says we're the number one brand with about 30% market share. Which means if there are 3 people buying a smartphone today in India, 1 out of 3 is a Xiaomi customer. Last quarter was pretty incredible for us. We shipped more than 10 million units. Now, this is incredible because not only for Xiaomi, but no other smartphone brand had ever shipped 10 million units in one single quarter. And it's the first time a brand has done this. Every time we come for a launch event, we of course talk about our online numbers, that we have 60% market share in the online segment. And out of the top 10 selling phones in online, 9 are Xiaomi devices. But there's another piece of our business which has helped us reach this kind of a scale, which is our offline journey. Now, offline we started only about a year ago. 1 year ago, our share in offline used to be less than 0.5%. And in just 1 year, it has grown 40x from less than 0.5% to today 20% market share in the online segment. Today, we are present in about 40 markets, 40 cities, and in 8 out of these 40 cities, we have already become number one as per the latest GFK report. These are cities like Delhi, Gurugram, Chandigarh, Meerut, Indore, Ranchi, Bengaluru, and Hyderabad. A big shout out to all our entire offline team, especially our offline team working in Meerut, which is my hometown, for making us number one in Meerut. Thank you. And I would again want to thank all our Mi fans for supporting us during this journey over the last 4 years. We recently completed 8 years globally, 4 years in India, and we celebrated our 8th anniversary with the Mi fans. And there were people, Mi fans who wrote us, thousands of Mi fans who wrote to us and told their story. For example, this Mi fan, Hari, he mentioned that he became a hardcore Mi fan last year when he bought Redmi Note 4, the most loved and the best-selling smartphone of 2017. Shubhajit, he again became a Mi fan last year when he bought Redmi 4, and then he convinced all his friends and family members to buy a Xiaomi device. And all our Mi fans really appreciate one thing about us, which is our philosophy, innovation for everyone, making technology affordable for every single person. And we believe there's another company which has a very similar kind of vision, which is Google. And we partnered with Google last time to launch an Android One device, which was called as Mi A1. A lot of people really love this device. A lot of you guys said great things about this device. For example, Android Central said, this is one of the best, if not the best, budget smartphone for 2017. TechRadar said, Mi A1 raises the bar for what one can expect in the mid-range Android smartphones. Let's see what all different people have to say. One stat that I forgot to mention. Mi A1 was one of the top 10 selling smartphones worldwide and was the best selling Android phone ever, period. There have been so many Android One devices launched, and this was the best selling Android One device. So let's look at a small video about what Mi fans have to say about Mi A1.
I work as a social media executive, and I'm 21.
I'm Ashwin, and I'm a 2017 graduate from IIT Madras.
Hi, I'm Arvind, the Bangalore-based cinematographer, and of course, a Mi fan.
Hi, my name is Rachita. I'm right now doing my post-graduation.
I'm Deep, and I'm 29 years old. By profession, I'm an engineer, and I'm also part of Bangalore Mi Fan Club.
It's got a really fancy look, and it's got a fingerprint sensor, so that makes it very easy for me to unlock. And it's got a really good camera, and you don't run out of space ever.
The Android One OS, it's pure Android experience that is very nice. The body and of the device is very slim.
The portrait mode in the MIUI One is so good. The edge separation is so perfect.
The low light photography mode, it needs a little improvement.
I'd like to see a bigger screen, probably an 18:9 aspect ratio.
There should be an increase of the megapixel, maybe a quick charging.
I think camera performance in low light. That's the only thing I would want to change about it.
Xiaomi.
So that was Mi A1. A lot of people really loved it. And here we are. Today we are extending our partnership with Google and we are launching Mi A2. The smartphone with a really great camera using which you can take picture perfect photos. There are three things which really stand out about Mi A2. First, the design. Second, its camera. And third, its performance. And we'll talk about each one of them. Let's start with design. To introduce Mi A2, I would like to show another short video. So that's Mi A2. You would have seen a lot of things on Mi A2. Let's talk about them. The first thing that you would notice about Mi A2 is its unibody aluminum design. It has very subtle, discrete antenna lines, which makes it look very beautiful. For the first time, we are also introducing the arc design, which not only makes it look very beautiful, but also very comfortable to hold. And you can have a very sturdy grip with Mi A2. On the bottom side, you'll find a very symmetric design and also a Type-C USB. And on the front, you will see 5.99-inch Full HD Plus full screen display. And for all our Mi fans, we also have Gorilla Glass 5, 2.5D Gorilla Glass 5. This is the first Xiaomi phone to be launched in India with Gorilla Glass 5. And it is also very slim, just about 7.3 mm. Now, how thin is 7.3 mm? We competed with few of the flagship phones like OnePlus 6. OnePlus 6 is 7.8 mm, and Mi A2 is only 7.3 mm thin. We're launching Mi A2 in four different colors: black, gold, very elegant rose gold, and my personal favorite, also very slim, just about 7.3 mm. Now, how thin is 7.3 mm? We competed with few of the flagship phones like OnePlus 6. OnePlus 6 is 7.8 mm, and Mi A2 is only 7.3 mm thin. We're launching Mi A2 in four different colors: black, gold, very elegant rose gold, and my personal favorite, also very slim, just about 7.3 mm. Now, how thin is 7.3 mm? We competed with few of the flagship phones like OnePlus 6. OnePlus 6 is 7.8 mm and Mi A2 is only 7.3 mm thin. We're launching Mi A2 in four different colors: black, gold, very elegant rose gold, and my personal favorite, we competed with few of the flagship phones like OnePlus 6. OnePlus 6 is 7.8 mm and Mi A2 is only 7.3 mm thin. We're launching Mi A2 in four different colors: black, gold, very elegant rose gold, and my personal favorite, we competed with few of the flagship phones like OnePlus 6. OnePlus 6 is 7.8 mm and Mi A2 is only 7.3 mm thin. We're launching Mi A2 in four different colors: black, gold, very elegant rose gold, and my personal favorite, Lake Blue. Let's look at each one of them. This is the black one. Also very slim, just about 7.3 mm. Now how thin is 7.3 some of the portrait pictures which have been shot on Mie 2 in outdoor condition. Of course, it also works on group pictures. Even if you have three or four people, each one of them will be in focus, and it will just beautifully blur the background. Now, when we launched Mie 1, a lot of you guys gave us feedback on how can we improve the video quality. So for that, we are introducing EIS, Electronic Image Stabilization, for Mie 2. And this ensures the video qualities for Mie 2 will be significantly better. I will show you a small video which compares Mie 1 versus Mie 2. Is powered again by Sony sensor, a 20 megapixel Sony sensor, Sony IMX376. On Mie 1, we did not have a selfie light, and we're introducing a selfie light on Mie 2. That too with 4500 Kelvin color, color, which is very similar to the natural light that you see outside. Now, during the day, the resolution is the king, and the 20 megapixel allows very vivid, very beautiful pictures with great detailing, both in the background as well as in the foreground. And during the night time, we have pixel binning, the same technology that we spoke about in the rear camera, where four pixels combine together to form a big pixel, and you can get very good quality pictures even in the night time. We also have auto HDR, both on rear and front, and we have Yash sir from our communication team, our PR team, who will explain how auto HDR works. If you just change the background there, depending on the background, the HDR will switch on. Now, I don't need to explain how HDR is helpful. All of you guys know this. This is a picture without HDR, picture with HDR. And as you can see, the background, which is outside the window, is completely washed away or blurred in case of without HDR. And it is beautifully captured with HDR. Same in outdoor conditions, the clouds, trees, leaves, everything is much more beautifully captured in case of HDR as compared to non-HDR. We also have the AI portrait mode on selfies. Now, this is something on which we have been investing a lot of time, energy, and effort. And our entire AI portrait selfies is based on our in-house AI algorithm, which again works on semantic segmentation, something that we spoke about. We go pixel by pixel, identify the human being or the person, and then naturally blur everything else. For the first time, we are also introducing AI bokeh enhancement. Now, what it does, apart from just blurring the background, it also identifies the entire background and the kind of scene it is, and will naturally beautify it a little bit, so that you get amazingly beautiful selfies, almost like a DSLR kind of pictures. Again, comparison in low light performance between Mie 2, OnePlus 6, and iPhone 10 when it comes to low-light portrait selfies. Now, if you look at this one, the middle one, I think, again, the color reproduction is the best. But even if you zoom in and you see, the light balls, the bokeh balls, are probably the best in case of Mie 2, almost like a DSLR kind of effect on a phone. Some more sample pictures for portrait selfies. This is in low-light condition. This is in a better lighting condition, outdoor, and also group portrait selfies. Now, when you usually take portrait selfies on many other phones, only one person will be in focus, others will get blurred, not with Mi A2. So this is the selfie camera for Mi A2, really great 20 megapixel Sony sensor. With pixel binning technology, you get 4-in-1 super pixels, AI bokeh enhancement, AI powered beautify, and a great selfie light. So this is the overall camera performance for Mi A2. On the rear, you have 12 megapixel plus 20 megapixel. Both the sensors from Sony. Both the sensors have large f1.75 aperture. We're introducing lens selection for the first time. In regular pictures, this is manual lens selection when you can switch between two different lenses. In case of portrait mode, this is smart lens selection. The change will happen automatically. On the front, 20 megapixel Sony sensor with AI portrait selfies and super pixels or pixel binning technology. Let's move to the third section, which is performance. But before we go to hardware, we really want to talk about our partnership here, our partnership with Google. And I would like to call on stage Mr. Pranab Mukin, who is the head of Android partnerships for Google India. Pranab. Yeah, welcome.
Thank you, Manu. Excited to be here with you, Manu. It's exactly, I think, 1 year since we launched our first partnership with the Mi A1 device. With Android One, we aim to bring devices with the best user experience to the market. We think this is accomplished by being highly selective in our choice of partnerships, right? Like Xiaomi, having great devices, and by ensuring that these devices get the best and the latest innovations from Google. We collaborate closely with Xiaomi on hardware and software to ensure that the combined user experience is of the highest quality and has the greatest experience. These messages are around our core user philosophy, quality, and innovation seem to be catching on. And that has given us a lot of confidence in order for us to expand our Android One portfolio with Xiaomi. With the Mi A2 device. So let's start with how smart the device is. The Mi A2 device is designed to get you through the day. Take the Google Assistant, for example. It can help you get things done by just using your voice. Tell it to pull up directions, call a friend, set an alarm. It's just there to help. Not only that, but the Google Assistant, over time, will pick up your preferences and becomes increasingly more useful the more you use it. It's your own personal Google, always ready to help. Another great example is photos. We all take them. It's how we keep and share some of the best moments of our lives. The Mi A2 and Manu talked about all the great amazing effects that the camera has. It can do amazing stuff like automatic background blurring, bright photo colors in any lighting, and just around any take great pictures. So when you take these pictures, you want to make sure that they are there for you forever. With Google Photos acting as a default gallery app, you're assured of this: unlimited high-quality photo storage always. It also comes with features such as automatic photo organization based on the people, places, and memories that matter. Ever wondered what was in a photo that you took a long time ago? Well, now, with Google Photos and Google Lens built in, you can easily identify the animal, the landmark, the book, or even that weird insect that you had in that photograph. These things are great. The camera, the smarts, the feel of the device. But if your battery doesn't last the full day, then it doesn't really matter in India. Out of the box, we at Google have run this device through a litany of tests to ensure a long-lasting battery for this device. Moreover, this will be one of the first devices to get Android P later this year. It will benefit from our latest battery innovations on P. That includes auto-adjusting screen brightness, adaptive battery feature that prioritizes background and activities based on your personalized usage patterns. Security. People's phones are incredibly personal, and we rely on them all the time to keep our information safe. We also want the safe information at our fingertips at all times. All Android One phones are committed to ensuring that your data is protected. So with Google Play Protect, your phone will be regularly scanned dynamically to help prevent malware, even if you're offline. Your phones will be reinforced with the latest security updates to ensure that it stays ahead of potential threats at any point in time. As with the Mi A1 and all other Android One devices, we want users to have an experience that's been user-tested for simplicity and convenience. These devices will come with minimal preloads, so your phone will not have any clutter on them. A feature set that's fully integrated with the underlying OS so that the device is fast and the user interface is easy to navigate and customize. Additionally, with functions such as notification snoozing, seamless autofilling, the phone adapts to your preferences. All this gives the user more control, flexibility on how they use their device. Last but not the least, when this device gets Android P, users will have the option to switch to Google's new system navigation that comes with a new intuitive way to interact with your device. I'm so proud of the efforts and collaboration between the Xiaomi team and the Google teams to help bring you another great Android One device. With that, I'll hand over to Manu. Thank you.
Thank you, Pranab. Thank you. So Mi A2, this is being powered by Snapdragon 660. Yes, the extremely powerful Snapdragon 660 processor. Now, this processor is powered by Qualcomm's AI engine, which allows us to use many of our own AI features, like our AI portrait mode or AI bokeh enhancement. This also has Spectra ISP, which allows us to have true-to-life colors and zero shutter lag. This is based on the latest Cryo architecture from Qualcomm, which is usually seen on only flagship 800 series, like Snapdragon 835, or Snapdragon 845. And now Qualcomm is bringing the same technology to Snapdragon 660. It has 8 cores. The 4 high-speed cores are for demanding tasks like gaming. And the 4 lower-clocked cores are used when you do stuff like browsing or texting. So you get best of both the worlds. Mi A2, powered by Snapdragon 660, has an end-to-end score of 139,000, which is 79% higher than Snapdragon 625 on Mi A1. Now, we always listen to you guys. There's a specific thing that many of our Mi fans, many of our media colleagues ask for, which is quick charge. So for India Mi fans, we are bringing Quick Charge 4 Plus. Now, the charger in the box is going to be the 10-watt charger. But you can buy the Quick Charge 3.0 from Mi.com or other reliable sources. And whenever 4.0 or 4 Plus is available, you can also buy it and use the technology. So that's the performance of Mi A2. Really best-in-class performance based on Android One platform, Snapdragon 660, Cryo architecture, Spectra ISP, AI engine, and Quick Charge 4 Plus. Every single unit of Mi A2 that will ship in India will be made locally here in the country. And Make in India has been a big, big initiative by Xiaomi India. This is something that we really take pride in. Our first factory was launched 3 years ago, in first week of August 2015. And since then, we have scaled up a lot. In the beginning of this year, we announced that we have set up 6 factories now, and we also launched a new factory, which was for PCBs. 2 days ago, we announced a new initiative where our partner Holitech said they are going to set up a factory for not just manufacturing phones and PCBs, but they are going to manufacture different components here in the country. They will manufacture 5 different components, like camera module, touch panel, fingerprint sensor, and few more here in the country. This will require an investment of 1,400 crores, 6,000 jobs to be created, And this will be situated in Tirupati, Andhra Pradesh, over a 75-acre land parcel. While we're doing all this manufacturing, we are making phones in India, we are making PCBs in India, now we are beginning to make all these components. By the way, we're the first smartphone company which will manufacture these kind of components in the country. Nobody has ever done this before in India. So while we're doing all of these stuff, there's one thing that we really focus on, which is quality. Now this is one slide that you might have seen earlier also, where we say for every single phone, we do a large number of tests. Even things like side button or fingerprint sensor, we test them 5 lakh times, 6 lakh times. And a lot of other brands will also show you similar kind of slides. And they will say, oh yeah, we also do quality tests. But the ultimate truth for all these quality tests is FFR, or what we call as field failure rate. Which means if we sell 100 devices, how many of these devices come back with any kind of hardware or software problem? There are no industry reports, but we believe our field failure rate based on our internal data would be today half of industry average. And by the way, here in industry average, we mean the top 5 players in the country. So yes, we believe Xiaomi phones would be the best in class, would have the best in class quality in the country. And in case if you face a problem, we have service centers. Today we have the largest service network in the country. We recently launched 1,000 service centers. And while we are opening new service centers, we're also focusing on improving the quality of our service. There's a recent report by Red Quanta, which looks at multiple different parameters like number of service centers, timeliness of service, quality of service, courtesiness of staff, and based on that, they come up with a comprehensive score. And this is the ranking for this year. We used to be much lower till about a year ago, but this year, Xiaomi has been rated as the best-in-class service network across the country. And there are a few other brands which have been there for many decades, and Xiaomi has been here only for 4 years, and still, Xiaomi has the best service network. So not only we are number one in sales, but also number one in after sales, which is equally important, if not more important. Thank you. Yeah. Coming back to Mi A2, so Mi A2 is a huge upgrade over Mi A1 in every single department. Mi A1 had Snapdragon 625, Mi A2 Snapdragon 660. Mi A1 had a front 5-megapixel camera, Mi A2 20-megapixel AI camera, Sony sensor with a selfie light. Mi A1 had 12+12 megapixel. Mi A2 has 12+20, both of them Sony sensor, both of them having 1.75 aperture with large pixel size of 1.25 on the primary 12-megapixel one. LPDDR4X RAM, 5.99-inch full-screen display, Bluetooth 5.0, Quick Charge 4+, and EIS for video recording. So, the last part, what should be the price of Mi A2? I think there were some sort of rumors floating around yesterday. And some people thought we have leaked the price, which was completely incorrect. I think they were fake pages. Before I go to price, I'll again show some of these flagship devices. Of course, you will say, why are we comparing them? Because we genuinely believe that Mi A2 has similar, if not better pictures than both these flagship devices. And while both of them are very expensive, Mi A2, we are launching at 16999. The 4GB, 64GB variant. I'll come to it. We also have comparison with other similar devices, like Samsung A8 Plus, which is the best-selling Samsung phone in the 30,000 rupee range, and Nokia 7 Plus, which is the only other Snapdragon 660 device. Of course, both of them are much more expensive as compared to Mi A2, which will sell at only 16999 with better specs, better features, better quality, and at a much lower honest price. Now, a question that some of the Mi fans here in the first row asked, what is happening to the other variants? We are launching 4+64. Are there more variants coming? So yes, we have also have 6+128, which will be coming very soon. Just stay tuned. Every single Mi A2, we will share more details very soon. Every single Mi A2 will have a premium soft case, which will come in the box itself.
Now, again, another feedback that a lot of you guys, our Mi fans, our media colleagues have given to us is against our flash sale system. And trust me when I say this, 4 years ago, we used to love flash sales. But over a period of time, as we have become bigger and bigger and we have become the number one smartphone brand, I think it is a moral responsibility to ensure that everybody can buy devices as easily as available. So we have been increasing our supplies. 1 year ago, we used to have 3 million supplies every quarter. We have more than tripled it to 10 million a quarter. We have been expanding our offline business. And now for the first time, we're also introducing pre-orders. So starting tomorrow itself, which is 9th of August at 12 noon, you can go and pre-order Mi A2 on both Mi.com and Amazon, our partners. So we're launching Mi A2 on Amazon. If you pre-order, these devices will be shipped within a week's time. If you don't want to wait, you can also buy it starting 16th of August at 12 noon on Mi.com, Amazon, and Mi Homes. And this will also be available across thousands of our Mi preferred partners. One last thing, there's a special gift from our partner, Reliance Jio. So Reliance Jio will give 2,200 rupee instant cash back for every Mi A2 customer. And again, for the first time, they will give 4.5 terabyte of data free with every single Mi A2. Thank you. So this is Mi A2 for you, for everybody. A really incredible device, an amazing camera. You can take picture-perfect photos. On the rear, you have 12 plus 20 megapixel, both Sony sensor, large f1.75 aperture, large 1.25 micron pixel. On the front, again, you have a Sony sensor, 20 megapixel camera, AI-powered Beautify, multiple other AI features, Qualcomm Snapdragon 660, and of course, the Android One platform. The 4GB, 64GB at 16999, and the 6GB, 128GB for all our core Mi fans coming very soon. Thank you so much, guys. That's all for today. Let's do a quick photo op. I'll also call on stage Mr. Pranab, if you can please join me. These two. This way. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Sorry? Oh, okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, maybe we can take it after this. So thank you so much, everybody, for joining in. Jivika? Okay, thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.